Hi everyone, in this video I'm going to be talking about cutting your hair in certain phases of the moon and the science behind this. Now, does a certain phase of the moon make your hair grow faster or slower? And where did this practice actually originate? Well, when I was doing research on this, I actually found a lot of contradicting information. So here's the gist of things, basically from the old farmer's almanac. What they say is that your hair is part of your body, and although it's not living in the exact same sense as the organs in your body are living, it's still an energy carrier. Everywhere in your body carries energy. That's why some people say that your hair stands up on end when you carry a static electric charge, because it's still carrying that charge all the way through your hair. So it stands to reason that if the phases of the moon, the positions of the moon and the constellations affect your body's energy, then it will also affect the energy in your hair. And if you want your hair to grow up optimally, what they recommend you do is to cut your hair at the time of the month that it's going to lose the least amount of energy. So what most sources have told me is if you want your hair to grow faster and longer, then you would want to cut it at the new moon or a few days after the new moon when it's in its waxing phase, and this will help it lose the least amount of energy. If you want it to grow fuller and thicker, then you would want to cut it around the full moon. But if you want to have your hair grow a little bit slower, then you would want to cut it when the moon is actually in its waning phase. Some sources also go into detail about what time of day you should cut your hair when the moon is in a certain constellation in the sky. And depending on what constellation this would be, it could cause your hair to grow faster, slower, thicker, or thinner. So is there any merit to this from a scientific standpoint? Well, one very creative suggestion was that since the moon can affect large bodies of water, like the ocean's tides, it can also affect us since we are technically bodies of water. Our bodies are over 80% water, and since the moon is right above us, then it can cause a little bit more blood to come to the top of our heads and flood our follicles with more nutrients. Well, if you follow the math, it doesn't really go that way. So let's calculate the gravitational pull of the moon on our bodies, shall we? So the gravitational force is the gravitational constant times the mass of one body, which would be the moon, times the mass of another body, being us, divided by the distance between our centers. Now that is an average. The moon is sometimes closer and sometimes further away. However, I will get into that later. So let's use me as an example at 57 kilograms, and let's use the average distance of the moon away from the Earth at 3.844 times 10 to the 8 meters. Now what you would get is 1.89 times 10 to the minus 3 newtons. So those are working with millinewtons now. I could get the same amount of gravitational pull from holding a 1 kilogram object about 1.4 millimeters away from my center of gravity. In other words, the moon is pulling on me about the same as this corset is. So the moon's gravitational pull is really not that significant. Now, is there any difference in the moon's mass from a full moon compared to a new moon? Not really. Now, the sun's light shining on the moon, which causes it to glow to us, is adding an infinitesimally small amount of mass to the moon. However, this occurs at all times with exception to a lunar eclipse, at which, of course, the Earth is actually casting a shadow on the moon. However, the sun is consistently shining on the moon at all other times, and the only reason that we see phases of the moon is due to the orientation of the sun and the moon relative to us. So the only other major variable in the equation is the distance from the Earth to the moon. Indeed, the moon does not have a perfectly circular orbit, it is elliptical. When it's at perigee, this is said to be the closest that the moon is to the Earth, and when it's at apogee, this is when the moon is furthest away from the Earth. However, there is no dependence whatsoever on the phases of the moon compared to where it is in its orbit. So now let's put the topic of the moon aside for a moment and talk about the hair side of things. And one of my biggest pet peeves is when people say that your hair grows faster when you trim it. No, this does not happen. Unless you do believe that there is energy coursing through your hair, there's no scientific evidence of any sort of magical force that signals to your follicles to grow hair faster when you cut the ends of the hair. It is a protein strand. Like I said, it's not living in the same sense that your cells are, so there's no direct feedback there. The only reason that you might think your hair is growing faster after a small trim is you're getting rid of your damaged ends, and with less breakage, it allows your hair to reach a longer length overall. Without the ends of the hair breaking off. However, it does not actually signal to your follicles to grow any faster or slower, not during a full moon, not during a new moon. So at this point, I have no scientific evidence that shows that cutting your hair during certain phases of the moon can stimulate your follicles to grow your hair faster or slower. My suggestion would be to trim your hair when it needs a trim. Now, it is convenient to follow the moon's phases. If you want to trim your hair, say, every 3 months, then you can cut your hair every third new moon. It's an easy way to keep track of things. However, if you do believe in cutting your hair during a particular phase of the moon, and if it's something that you've always done, then by all means keep on doing it. There are many things in this world that science cannot yet explain, and even if it doesn't hold any water from a scientific standpoint, then you can at least look forward to a placebo effect. So thank you all for making it to the end of this video with me. If you cut your hair by certain phases of the moon, then certainly let me know. And if you have any evidence to support cutting your hair during particular phases, then certainly leave a comment down below or post a video response. I will see you all in a few days with the next video. Bye.